This week at Inside Bobcat Athletics, we'll take a look back at the 2013 softball season with head coach Ricci Woodard. Plus, highlights for the Bobcat baseball team. But first, we'll start off this week's show by going back to Arlington to the championship performances for the Bobcat men and women track athletes for the outdoor championships.
This has been an incredible year. It's unbelievable. I mean, indoors we knew we had a shot and it was a nail biter. Outdoors, we still thought it was going to be a nail biter, but the girls came out here and just lit this place on fire, and it was fun to watch everybody rise up.
Today was Operation Maroon Podium.
Yeah!
I think we accomplished that. We're pretty proud. I mean, we came in here to get our girls on top, and that's what we did.
We picked up where points might have slacked off yesterday. We picked up. I'm just ecstatic, so thankful for all the support that I've had, and I can't believe it really happened. I didn't expect it. I was just jumping heights, not knowing what it was at feet, and I'm just
forgetting,
like,
a huge, oh my gosh, new PR.
Forgetting I even PR'd, so.
Right.
Ready strong in lane four. Kim Young from Texas State.
Nice job, Tim!
For second. In second place, Sandra Venegas from Texas State at 35-25-11.
My teammates asked me before the race what I want to hear, and just anything positive, throw it at me. Anything funny to serious, they give it to me. They tell me to stay strong. At the end, they tell me my calves look great. It helps mentally.
They stepped up big. I didn't think it was going to be as close, you know. I knew it was going to be close, but not a 1-point difference. But I did know it was going to come down to the 4x4. And I've been telling my guys all year long, okay, this championship comes down to the 4x4. Are you ready? And they were ready. That's just the goal from here on out. Every team has to believe that we're a championship team, and they have to come in hungry and they have to want to win. And that's what I want. I want good student athletes and I want hungry competitors. And like I tell them, it's fun to win, guys.
Three!
And congratulations to Coach Boone, the men and women's outdoor track coach of the year, on top of the indoor coach of the year as well. Coming up next, we'll speak with Bobcat head softball coach Ricci Woodard with a recap of the 2013 season.
When he gets here, separate and make the tackle.
All in.
Innovation. Exploration. Creative discovery. These are the trademarks of Texas State University. As the state's newest emerging research university, we're transforming your world one mind at a time. Your world. Our research. Texas State University. The rising star of Texas.
And here we are at the softball complex at Texas State alongside the head coach of the program, Ricci Woodard, and we're going to recap the 2013 for Bobcat softball. And coach, just to start with the results of the WAC tournament, you dropped the opener to UTSA, come back, get wins over Louisiana Tech and UT Arlington, but then come up short against New Mexico State. So it's tough to win three games in one day, but you came one game within doing that and one game within making the championship final in Ruston, Louisiana. If you can, just talk to us about what your team did to put yourselves in a position like that after losing the opener.
Well, I think the big thing was, you know, losing the opener was one thing, and then we had the rain delay where we didn't get to play the game we should have played on Thursday, which put us in a bind for Friday. But, you know, I couldn't be more proud of the group and the way they battled those last three games. You know, from where we started the season to where we ended the season, I couldn't have been more proud of that group of kids and the way they got after it for three solid games on Friday. A lot of teams, knowing they had to play three on Friday, would have just folded on the first game, and they didn't.
Well, your two bankers made the all-tournament team, Kelly and Brooke, a senior and a freshman, and kind of fitting the way that they hit the ball season for you, two of your top three hitters. They had a very good tournament out in Ruston, Louisiana.
They did. You know, they did exactly what they're capable of doing. They put the ball in play and they got on base. You know, that's why they were both brought here. I think you'll see a little bit more out of Kelly Baker in the next 3 years as far as some power goes to her game. But you talk about a kid that just gets after it nonstop. It's nice to have that one returning. And, you know, Brooke Baker did a great job for us last year. And so to have her be able to finish her career the way she did at the tournament was also good to see.
Macy Hare, I thought, had a pretty good tournament as well. Hit a big home run to the win over UT Arlington. Finished the tournament with three RBI, and one of six seniors that wrapped up her career for you this past week in Ruston, Louisiana. When you look at this group, the part of a very special run here at Texas State, what have they meant to you in your program?
Well, yeah, just when you look at what we've been able to accomplish over the last 4 years, it tells you what they mean to this program. You know, for a kid like Macy Hare, who wasn't real successful as a freshman, to be as successful as she was as a senior, tells you the time and the effort that they put into to making this program what it is. You know, it was a rough year for them to have to kind of finish the way they did. But, you know, I think they learned a lot as freshmen to their senior year and just in life in general. The life lessons they got out of these 4 years, I think, is what will carry them through, you know, the rest of life. Because they did, they all got after it. They had some success, they had some failure, and they learned to battle through things, Brent. And that's really all you can ask for as a coach.
Now, one of the seniors, though, didn't get a chance to do too much on the field, and that was Anne Marie Taylor. Tore her ACL early on in the season, and really made things difficult for you. So you put a lot of responsibility on the shoulders of Ashley Wright and Rainhouse throughout the season to handle the pitching load. How do you feel like they were able to handle that throughout the course of the season?
Well, it's a good and bad thing. You know, I mean, you got two kids that didn't have much experience at this level that got a whole lot of experience in a hurry. And so for the future of things, you know, it'll put them in a better spot and us, you know, as a pitching staff in a better spot for next year. But yeah, wasn't what we foresee. They foreseen things happening this year as they went down. But you know, they both came in and did a great job. You know, at times for us, and other times struggled, which is kind of what you would expect. And so to see them both go out and finish the way they did on that Saturday or Friday of the conference tournament for us, and that day, you know, where they were going to have to get through three games, pretty much just the two of them together, I thought they did a great job of giving us a chance to win every single ball game.
Now, there's no doubt that this season was one of your toughest since arriving at Texas State back in the year 2000. When you look back at this season, what will you remember about it, and what are your expectations of the program now moving forward?
After the first and second weekends kind of struggling and then trying to figure out how to just maintain and struggle through, I think for me as a coach, it kind of made me sit back and reevaluate not only myself as a coach, but the program in general, which I think is always a good thing. But, you know, for the long run of things, I think things happen for a reason, and I think as we go through life, we'll learn, you know, kind of what the reasoning was for this year. But as the season went on, I think these kids really learned how to struggle and deal with adversity, you know, because it kind of just kept hitting them. And they just figured out there at the end how to just battle when they needed to battle. And that's I think, the thing that I wanted them to get out of this season the most was that, you know, life's going to be full of adversity, and it's about, you know, your choices and how you handle it. And I thought, again, they did a great job of getting into the tournament, first of all. And then once they got into the tournament, they played their tail ends off. And you can't really ask for anything more than that.
And you'll be going into your third conference in as many years as coming this now next season, the Sun Belt, which has been a very good softball conference.
Right, and even better. I mean, this year they got two at-large teams into the tournament. And, you know, last year they finished number 7 in the country RPI-wise, and I think they're going to finish higher than that this year. So, yeah, we better get back on track in a hurry, and the pitching staff is where it's going to start.
Well, just like the Bobcats did to the WAC tournament, bouncing back, we expect the same thing for the program going into the 2014 season. Coach, thanks so much for your time.
Thanks, Brent.
will not lose. Ever. Ever. Turn my music high, 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 high,
Welcome back to Inside Bobcat Athletics. Now we take a look at some highlights from the Bobcat baseball team's conference series at UT Arlington and the Cats' final non-conference midweek game against Rice. Thanks again to Coach Boone and Coach Woodard for joining us in this week's show. Tune in next time when we take a look back at the Bobcat baseball season and recap the 2012-2013 year as a whole for Bobcat Athletics. For Inside Bobcat Athletics, I'm Brant Freeman.